What's up, YouTube? I have been contacted a lot recently by people who are struggling with their nutrition on the weekends. So listen up and tell me if this sounds like you. You do great during the week. You are nailing your nutrition guidelines, your calories and your protein. You're organized with meals pretty good during the week. And then the weekend happens. And it's like you're out running errands, your kids have got stuff to do, you're going out for lunch, and then you're out for dinner, and then you're meeting up with friends later that evening, and then the next morning you have a brunch with the family, and by the time the weekend's over, your calories have well exceeded your calorie guidelines, and maybe really exceeded the calorie guidelines to the point of potentially negating any of the progress that you made during the week. Does that sound like you? If so, you're not alone. A lot of people have this issue. And what we find is that the amount of calories that they're consuming on a weekend is just completely negating their progress during the week. And so they are in a constant spinning of that hamster wheel. They can't get out of it. They do really, really well for a while, and then they let it all go on the weekends. And then they start it all over again. And so we're constantly going in this wheel and we can't get out of it. So let's talk about that for a second. I think a couple things are the cause. A couple things pop out right away. The first thing is sometimes you can be a little too restrictive during the week, meaning you are keeping your food vocabulary super small, which means just the foods that you eat, the variety of foods you eat, are very, very small. You don't eat many foods at all, as far as variety. You stick with the same foods all the time, and you never really stray outside of that little bubble of foods. So you're being overly restrictive, so that when the weekends come, it's kind of like you wanna have a cheat meal or whatever you wanna call it, and a cheat meal turns into a cheat day, which turns into a cheat weekend, and then it's gotten way out of control. And that if you back up the clock, it all comes from being maybe too restrictive during the week. And I'll come back to that in a second. The second reason weekends can get out of hand very, very quickly is because there's no preparation. We have not made a plan for the weekend. And that's where most people go wrong. They have no plan at all. They're kind of winging it on the weekends and flying by the seat of their pants. And so I think if we take just a little bit of time to come up with some a plan for your weekend, some ideas that you can implement during the weekend to help keep calories under control. Now, will they be perfect? Maybe not. Maybe they won't be perfect, but they will be in more control, and you won't have to hit that reset button every single Monday like you've been having to do up to now. Okay, so a couple of things that you can do right out of the gate. If you know that you're going to a party in the evening on a Saturday night or something, or even on a Friday evening, whatever it is, spend that day eating super light. Protein and veggies, that's what you do during the day. And keep your calories well under until you get to that event. That gives you a little bit more wiggle room to have your favorite drink, to have your favorite food, whatever it is. So that's one way. Just keep the calories pretty light, stick to protein and veggies. Another thing that you can try is, again, if you know that you're gonna be out on the run or you're going to go to an event and you wanna have a little bit of wiggle room for that event, have a little protein shake before you hit the road. A protein shake will take the edge off of hunger, and if you're out running errands, you're gonna be less likely to go through the drive-thru and get your burger and fries or something like that, because that protein shake's gonna help kind of keep you feel full a little while, and it's not really, it's not high in calories, and it will keep you feeling full, take the edge off that hunger a little bit. And if you're going to an event, then that protein shake before you go is going to help keep the munchies down for sure. So when you go to that party and there's all this food sitting out there, you will not just go over there and start mindlessly grabbing handfuls of whatever, and then before you know it, it's gotten way out of control there too. Okay, so those are two things right away that you can try and implement. Are they going to be perfect and keep your calories perfectly in check? No, but that's not our goal. That's not our goal. Our goal is to keep everything in control the best that we can and do the best we can with what we can do. The biggest thing that you can do that I think works super, super well is give yourself what's called some bright lines. Bright lines are basically non-negotiable rules that you give yourself before you go to a party or before you go to a dinner out or something like that. So it could go something like this. If you normally go to a party and you tend to have like 3-4 drinks or 3-4 glasses of wine or whatever, and you tend to munch, then you want to kind of keep that under control. So here's what you do for a bright line. Here's an example of what you could do. You could say, okay, I'm going to go to this party. I'm going to allow myself 2 glasses of wine and 1 small plate of food. So when I go to this party, I can put whatever I want to on this plate, whatever I want to. But once that plate of food is gone, I am done. That's it. I'm done. I have my 2 drinks and my 1 plate of food. That's it. And after that, you start with a club soda or water or whatever. So what could have been a 4 and 5 drink night plus unlimited snacking and munching is now under control and is now 2 drinks and a small plate of food. That is a rule that you give yourself. It's a bright line that you do not cross. It's non-negotiable. And so you do it. And what happens is afterwards, you are not feeling bad. You are not feeling guilty. You did what you set out to do. And the best thing about bright lines is this. You have zero anxiety going into this party. Before, maybe you were worried about, oh my God, how am I going to control myself? How am I going to do this? How I'm going to go over my calories? I'm going to blow it, all that kind of stuff. Anxiety can be real. Like, you want to keep everything under control. And if you don't have anything in place, it's probably going to get out of control. But what you've done with a bright line is you've set the rules ahead of time. So now there's no question as to what's going to happen. You know what's going to happen. You will have 2 glasses of wine or 2 drinks or whatever, and 1 small plate of food. That's it. That's it. And you can put whatever you want on that plate of food. Yeah, pile stuff on there, but it's just 1 plate. So what we've done is we've taken a situation that could get massively out of control, like 3,000 to 4,000 calories easily out of control for an evening like that. And we've grabbed the reins, pulled them in. We are still able to be social. We're still able to enjoy ourselves. We're still able to enjoy the food and the drinks, but we're in control. We are controlling the entire evening. And if I can tell you one thing, there's something so empowering about setting up some rules like that, following through, doing them, and leaving there feeling like, shit, look what I just did. I mean, the confidence that comes out of that is amazing. And that sets you up for future weekends, future events, whether they're on a weekend or not, it doesn't matter, but it will set you up for keeping events under control. And again, remember, we're not trying to be perfect because that's just not going to happen. We are just trying to get control over it and keep our anxiety down and be able to still maintain our progress and still move forward instead of always, always having to hit the reset button. So give yourself a bright line the next time you're going to a party. Give that a try. And I want you to message me and I want you to let me know how that went. And as a matter of fact, if you want to, message me ahead of time, what is your bright line? Like, if you're going to a party on Saturday night, message me, tell me, what is your bright line going to be? Let me know. I would love to know. And then I want you to tell me how it went. Is it successful 100% of the time? Well, nothing is. But here's the thing. If you're not successful at it the first time you try it, you get up, you dust yourself off, and you do it again. And you know what? The more you do it, the more success you're going to have. So we're all a work in progress, but give this a try. I guarantee you, you will have way more success with your weekends. You won't miss out on any of the fun and the company and the food and the drinks. You will be able to enjoy yourself. Absolutely. And the best part is you won't have to ever feel guilty about it again, ever. So you've got your homework. try some bright lines for your next event, and I need to know about them. I want to know. I want to know how you're doing. And if you have any questions about any of this, please plop them here or send me a message and let me know. And be sure and hit subscribe here, because I'm posting a whole lot more here on YouTube now. I am posting a lot of workout tutorials in particular, and I'm going to start doing some vlogging too coming up. So be on the lookout. So hit subscribe so you know when all that's coming out. Okay? And if I can ever do anything for you, always, always, always let me know. I'm always here. Take care, you guys.